Okay, welcome to pdfsupply.com. Today we're going to be testing a 9030 series CPU352. I have a specific part number here, IC693CPU352. You don't have to worry about the letters that follow 352. It's going to be the same test for all of them. I'm placing that in an IC693CHS397 5-slot rack. There's no other modules in the slots, so this will just be an isolated test on the CPU. And I'm using a IC693PWR330 power supply. Now that that's in there, I'm going to go ahead and power it up. And the first thing I'm going to look for is an OK light on the power supply. This tells me that the CPU is worthy of testing, that there's no major problems so far. If you do not get that light, then you have a deeper problem with the processor. You're not going to be able to follow this test. You'd have to stop right now. And the problems can vary a lot. It could be a number of different things. And this is something that we typically look at and we find wrong with processors, and we can diagnose. Next, we're going to go to the Proficy Machine Edition software. I have chosen a file here, just a test file. It's a simple file. It's a blank file, no program, something that will allow me to get the CPU into run mode. And I've opened the rack just to make sure that the configuration in the rack is the same rack, power supply, CPU, and there's no other modules in the other slots for this test. In the upper left-hand corner of the screen, I'm going to want to get connected to the CPU. Connect the software to the CPU using this lightning bolt icon. Now that it's connected, I can monitor down below here. There's this status bar. It tells me that it's in monitor mode, stop, disabled, outputs are disabled, configuration equal, logic equal. Then I'm going to go to the handprint, top left again, toggle to online mode or programmer mode as it says down here. And now that it's in programmer mode, I'm going to go to target, go to clear, and I want to clear the controller fault and I/O tables. The rest of these memory, you don't want to erase anything else. You just want to erase any faults that will prevent us from going online. So now that I've chosen those two, I'm going to hit OK. Yes, we'd like to erase those. And now we're starting fresh. Now I can download and run this configuration using this download and run button, which is the download information symbol and run. And the first thing that it's going to ask us once it gets there during this build is, what do we want to download? We'd like to download hardware, configuration in motion, and logic. We don't want to download anything else. We don't want to download anything to the flash memory. This is just a simple test to make sure that the device works. I'm going to hit OK. And we're going to try and test all aspects of the CPU. First is getting it into run mode before we can test the other ports, switches, and we're going to hit OK to get into run mode. However, if you look down below in the feedback zone, it's going to say the controller is not in run mode after you attempted to start it. This may be due to a run-stop switch position application. That's true. If you right-click on the CPU and look at your configuration, what I've done is I've enabled the key switch run stop feature. I do that because it has two features. One's run or stop, the other one is on or off. On or off is referring to the memory protection. So this is a functional part. We're going to turn this key to the on mode or run mode, and now we're in run mode. Okay. And of course, if you look in the Proficy, you'll see that your status has been moved to run mode. All right. Now that it's in run mode, I want to test the two ports, port 1 and port 2, on the CPU itself, port 1 and port 2. I'm going to do that by using this SNP cable. That's this cable here. I'm going to plug it right into the RS485 port. And immediately I have a connection, I have communication. port 2 is blinking, and that tells me that it's responding, that it works. And if you look at the status, of course, in Proficy, nothing's changed. It's all the same. It hasn't lost connection. Now that that works and I'm sure of it, I can take that back off, put it back to the power supply. And the next test is port 1. This is a little bit different of a cable. It's like a telephone jack on one end and a serial port on the other end. The part number is IC693CBL316. And it's a programmer cable, so I'm going to go ahead and plug that into port 1. And now I've got to make a change to the other side of the port on the computer. Plug that in, and immediately I have a connection. That's what I need. So now we've tested the CPU, can go into run mode, it's okay. Ports 1 and 2 are working. The on-off or run-stop switch is working properly. So that pretty much concludes the test. If you still have a problem with the CPU, or if you think you do have a problem, leave it in run mode the way that we have it right now. Leave it overnight. Leave it over a weekend if you can. And if it's not in run mode when you come back, something triggered it to fail, so you go to target in that case, in the event that it gets kicked out of run mode, and you want to look for any faults. Now, we have a fault here that tells us that there's no program present, which is accurate. This is just a simple test. There is no program, so that's correct. But that's not something that would take us out of run mode. If you did have a problem, you can always click on whatever the fault is, and it'll open up and give you an error code and some information on that fault. And if it's something that you can't figure out, again, we could always help. You can reach us at 1-800-360-6802. We're happy to help. Any repairs, we have exchange policies. And I hope you found this video helpful. Thank you.